Stoduto. I had some trouble with the accent, but I think I said correctly. And from UNIMED, Mediterranean University Union in Italy. We will have a look about the capacity building and an overview of the RAISD training resources. The RAISD training opportunities have been designed to build capacity of the staff working at the action research units, as we have seen, thanks also to Raniero, and committed to implement the inclusion strategies, the ties that we have seen during these 2 days of conference for selected vulnerable groups. So, Emilia, you have the floor. It's all yours.
Thank you, Giovanni. Good morning, everybody. I will be very quick. I will show you what has been done also to support the Action Research Unit to go through their tailored attention and inclusion strategies. Meanwhile, the project has designed a training that was addressed to the staff working in what is called the Action Research Unit to reach out the knowledge needed to move in these innovative attention and strategies tailored upon the vulnerability context. So UNIMED, together with the partners, has designed these courses through a need analysis, which was specific for each ARU. The learning outcome, of course, were mainly focused on developing an advanced expertise to effectively analyze the specific challenges and needs of the vulnerable group identified by each ARU, update the skill that were needed to move forward and promote the strategies of each ARU, and really make effective these strategies and meaningful, responsive, and also sustainable. So and this should have been done also sharing experience, not only between peers, but also among experts and peers. And another aspect was to improve the use of digital tools, because virtual collaboration was needed also because of COVID. In fact, because of COVID, the training was a little bit adjusted, not only in terms of carrying on everything online, but also integrating some topics that were more focused on online tools and participatory approach also in a virtual meeting. But one of the effects that we can say is a bit positive of the COVID was that having setting everything online, the training was also held synchronous since November 2020 up to February 2021, and also there were the possibility to follow the training in a later stage. So as Nazi was saying, the members of the ARU were changing, but they have also the possibility to follow the course online in a little moment. So, okay. very quick and very close to what has been done. The module of the training were 7, and these 7 modules were adapted to every kind of need that came out from the analysis done. So it was talk, it was showed how a participatory approach and inclusive communication skill would have been useful in live meeting and also in virtual meeting. It was talk about how to rethink and how to know more the responsible research and innovative principle that the project research talk about. Of course, because of COVID, it was, as I was mentioned earlier, used and discussed and explained more some tools and technologies to be used online. and also to access to other resources that are available online to be used by the trainers and by the staff working in the action research unit. Of course, it cannot be missed at focus on the gender issue and also the participatory approach and empowerment process dedicated to women in mainly in the Middle East and North African region, but of course there were examples that were more wider. There were some courses, which is I don't mention earlier, some courses were more horizontal, addressing all the ties, and other modules were more focused to be more generic and explaining what the ties should be evaluated and they should work. So this was held by ANTI, the module 5. And another module was about the funding opportunity and building of the partnership in project working on this topic. And the last but not least module was about the psychological support and trauma management, because all the staff working in the action research unit deal with person, as we have heard and see the documentary yesterday, with people that get through hard stuff. I'm saying this because you can find all these resources online. They are open, accessible for all. And this course has been capacity building during the implementation project. And this is a sort of bridge to the sustainability of the project, because this is a resource that is included in the observatory that Lisa will show to us later on. Thank you.